Assalamu alaikum and hello YouTube, my name is Nur Muhammad from AnimeWatch and I'm back with another SOTC or State of the Collection, right? So today, I'm gonna be making this video in about maybe three parts video. So today we're going to start with the watch that I like most, which is the Diverse Watch Collection. So I have no idea how much I have, so hopefully I will try to finish this under 30 minutes so that you don't really have to, you know, wait that long to see what do I have latest in my collection. But and yeah, so let's check it out and I'll see you soon. Okay guys, so welcome back. So this is not the entire diverse watch collection that I have, but of course at the end we will see all of this in one shot. I'm just gonna be showing you guys according to the chronological order. So from the first watch that I've bought until the latest dive watches that I've bought, and this is the first one. Oh, before we do that, let's do a quick wristwatch check. Today I'm not wearing my watch. This is an on loan from a bro. So this is my buddy's WK at chrono.path on Instagram. So he kindly loaned me this awesome, beautiful looking Tudor Black Bay 58 in blue. Awesome watch, right? So let's just go on with watch number one, which is this a micro brand which is called the Obris Morgan Predata. So this is I can't remember the model, maybe whether this is the third or the fourth model that they have produced. And yeah, it is quite a, you know what, this is the only black PVD coated watch that I have in my collection. So this features a 43 millimeters in case width and quite a long case lug to lug of 50 millimeters. And yeah, this is one of the reason that I don't really use this anymore. So it features it has this 22 millimeters lug and it's quite heavy piece. So it didn't come with this NATO strap, but it come with a full engineer bracelet, which when I put it on, it weighs about 190 grams, and that is way too heavy, right? So after I've got this watch, I never bought any black PVD watches after that. So yep, that is why this one must be, you know, I just wore it like maybe two or three times in a month, and I've had this for about 7 years already, and you know what, maybe it is going out of the collection soon enough, right? But anyway, this is my first ever automatic mechanical watch, which is using this Miyota 9015, and awesome. Well, let's just give it a shake and check out that smooth sailing second hand, right? Yep, nope. Okay, maybe it's the other way around. Yep, that is right. So 20,800 beats per hour, very very nice looking second hands. But you know what? If I've bought the stainless steel version, I would still use it. But now, yeah, it's just too heavy and too big for my taste. Right. So that's watch number one. Let's go to watch number two, which is my first ever Seiko. This is the Seiko Monster Gen 2 SRP313K1, featuring a 42 millimeters in diameter, 48 mm lug to lug, 13.5 millimeters in thickness, and this awesome 20 millimeters lug. And I have been using, from all the Seiko bracelet that I have, Seiko watches that I have, I think the Seiko Monster bracelet is the best. Still, I didn't really like the clasp, so that is why I put it on this cheap milk clasp that I've got from AliExpress. But I still need to readjust this thing. But still, this is an iconic watch for me. This is my first ever Seiko, and of course Seiko, when I had this watch, I was like, oh damn, the Alum is absolutely awesome, guys. So yeah, you can't really go wrong with a Seiko, and I think a Seiko Monster is a must have for any Seiko collector, right? So that is watch number two. Let's go to watch number three, which is this Seiko Turtle Putty, right? So this is my first ever Seiko Turtle, and yeah, it features this 45 millimeters diameters and a 47 millimeters lug to lug. And this is, you know what, when they first released the reissue of the Seiko Turtle, I didn't really bother to even look at it. But when they released the Seiko Putty version, in fact, this is the first ever Seiko Putty collaboration between Seiko and Putty, And I think this is the best dial ever, and they didn't really make any of this type of dial up until now. And I think the latest colorway, the Putty colorway, is just ridiculous. And I still think that if you want a Seiko Putty, this is the best color combination possible, right? So yeah, of course, it at 45mm, it still feels a bit too big, but because of the short lug to lug, I can easily wear this. But still, that 22mm lug width will make the watch feel a bit too big. Yeah, but still, I just love this thing, and I think this one also will not go anywhere. Right, so let's watch number 3. Let's go to watch number 4. Which is this Citizen NY0040. So this is the only left-hander on it. Not left-hander, this is lefty crown here. So you know what this thing is, I've done many videos using this particular watch, and I've said many times that I prefer this NY series against the ever popular Seiko SKX, because I just think proportionally the design is great on this particular piece, right? So I just prefer it over the SKX, right? Of course, it features I think it's 41mm in diameter and 46mm from lug to lug, and a thickness of just under 13mm, 20mm lug width. So very, very nice. And it is the only watch that I have in my collection which features this full lume dial, but unfortunately, the Citizen full lume dial is not really as strong as the Seiko Lumibrite. So yeah, if I am to do a lume battle, this would definitely lost the battle to any Seikos. Yeah, so yeah, it's a shame, but I do really like the design, and I've been thinking of selling this many times, but so many of you told me, hey man, do not ever sell that watch because you are not going to be able to find it again. And yeah, they are true, right? So let's go to watch number 5. Oh, before we go to this particular watch, I totally forgot to talk about the movement that is available on this particular piece. So this features the Muta 8023, yeah, I can't remember the name, but this is using the 8000 series movement. So it features a hand winding movement, but not hacking. That one is 9015, so awesome movement. And the movement on the Seiko Monster and the Seiko Turtle are both using the 4R36. So yeah, and good, let's get back to this particular, the fifth watch of in my diverse collection. This is the Masahiro Kanji, a micro brand from Australia. So they kindly met from Math and Son watches company, kindly sent me to review this watch, and I didn't really have to return it back. And yeah, that is an awesome watch. It's mimicking this Iru Kanji jellyfish, right? That dude, that is they say that this is a very, very venomous, the most deadliest fish, or no, jellyfish in Australia. So that is why I'm not gonna be going to any sea anytime soon, right? So yeah, it features it's actually 42mm, but because of the case design, right, so it tapers quite a lot. So this end is actually 42mm, and from lug to lug it's just, I think it's 46, and quite a tall case of about 14mm with a 20mm lug. So quite a unique case design, and yeah, that blue, that sunburst blue looks really, really beautiful. Quite a nice, unique design for their first ever watch. Of course, this one is using the Seiko NH35, and check out that single dome sapphire crystal. This thing is a pain in the ass to photograph, right? So that is what I can tell you guys. I've tried to take so many photos using my, you know, my camera, my phone. It's very, very difficult to take, but a cool watch nonetheless. Will it stay in the collection though? I don't know, man. I'm on the fence about this one. You know, what do you guys think? Should I keep it, or should I just sell it to fund more watches, right? So yeah, do let me know in the comment section below. So that is watch number 5, and let's go to watch number 6. Which is my Seiko Monster 4th generation SRP D25K1. So right, this is the, I think, one of the first two models that came out for this Seiko Monster 4th gen, somewhere in maybe early 2020, or is it end the end of 2019, right? So it's some people say that this is not a real monster because monster should have this, you know, this Dracula and this, you know, how to say, athletic or an angry looking thing. But this one, when this fourth gen came out, it doesn't really look that aggressive. That's the word I'm searching for. It looks a bit more matured because of the rectangular anuses here, and it comes with this blue, actually it's a bit more blue plus green, and it comes with this this is black iron plated bezel, so it is a little bit muted, little bit, you know, more mature in my opinion. And some of the Seiko fans absolutely hate that candy bar Cyclops, yo. So yeah, I don't really mind it because, you know, my eyes are failing, so I can't really see tiny things now. So that is why I prefer to have this Cyclops. But yeah, some people don't like it, and some people just take it out. So I'm not going to be doing that anytime soon. But still, yeah. Okay, so case featuring a 42mm in diameter and lug to lug of 48.5, a bit longer compared to Gen 2. And you can see that the design of the bezel of this cutout, this bezel and also the case is quite a lot different compared to the second and third gen monster. But I really, really like it. So because, like I mentioned just now, it is a more mature monster. Of course, at the back we have that Seiko Hokusai wave pattern here, right? So yeah, awesome watch for the money. If I am to choose between the Gen 2 or the Gen 4, yeah, maybe I go for the Gen 2 any time of the day. But still, it is an awesome watch, right? Of course, and one more thing is this watch is a gift for my wife, so I am never ever going to sell it because it is it has that sentimental value in it, right? So let's go to watch number 7, which is one of my first ever, no, not really my first, this is I think the third Chinese special watches that I bought from, I think I've bought this from Heimdallah, not from AliExpress. But yeah, of course Heimdallah, you can always buy them on AliExpress and stuff. But still, I wanted to check out the design of the Seiko Captain Willard, and I don't really want to spend that much money, $1,000 for the real thing. So that is why I think that, you know, for something that costs less than $150, so why don't I give it a try? So there are tons of options, of course, in AliExpress. You can always go for the still lifes, but still I went for the Heimdallah because I think on the picture at least it looks like this features a much more higher quality. And it is just a little bit, but not that much. Of course, the steel dive comes with a full bezel insert, a loom bezel insert, but this one does not. The dimension of this particular piece is 44mm in diameter, lug to lug of just about 47mm, and quite a thin case of under 13mm, and it features this 20mm lug, which makes this the most versatile watch that I have in my collection. I've paired it with tons of different colors and strap colors, and it just looks absolutely cool, right? So, and of course that Heimdallah Shark logo there, it's just nice looking in my opinion, right? So of course the case design, the dial design is mimicking the Seiko Captain Willard, which is very, very, not historic, what do you call this, very, very popular design from the movie Apocalypse, right? So yeah, still nice watch to be had, and surprisingly sits very, very well on the wrist, right? Especially for us skinny wrist guys, right? So that is watch number 7, and let's go to number 8. Which is my first ever Saint Martin. This is the Saint Martin, another brand from AliExpress. And you know what? I've been hearing when I purchased this watch somewhere around January 2021. So I've heard so many good things about Saint Martin. So you know what? I need to check out this thing. So I just there are tons of good reviews talking about Saint Martin or Saint Martin on the YouTube. So you know what? I just had to pull the trigger. So, and I wanted to compare to see whether I like this 6105 8000 case design compared to this 6105 8110 design. And the 309 case design, right? So of course I've done comparison video review comparing these three case shape, and you know what, that, yeah, I think that video went well. But still, yeah, let's talk about this particular piece. So you see that beautiful MOP or mother of pearl dial. Very, very nice shimmering. It's quite difficult to get that dial though, so it's, you have to play with the light so that you can see that beautiful dial. Some people say that this dial type is just for women. I don't think so. I think it's very, very nice looking in my opinion, and it, I just love this steel bezel insert. Of course they do come, this watch does come with the that what, Hokusai pattern or Kanagawa with pattern dial, that is with full lume pattern dial. So I don't really like that because it's just way too busy for me. I just wanted something that I could use day in, day out, not only during the weekend, right? So very, very nice case shape. I just love how this combines the 6105 design plus with the 62 mask design, and with that we've got this slab sided case. Oh sorry, the dimension is 42 millimeters, 47 millimeters from lug to lug, and a thickness of about I think it's about 13 millimeters, and we have a 20 millimeters lug width, right? Awesome, awesome watch. And I just don't understand why people don't like, they don't really sell that much of this, right? So that is why sometimes you can get this for quite a great price of under $150, and that, I can't remember how much that I bought it, but yeah, I've seen it went as low as $150, so which is an awesome, awesome watch for the money, right? So let's go for the next one, the ninth watch in my collection, in my diverse watch collection, which is this awesome Zelos Swordfish, another micro brand. This time around it is not from Hong Kong or from Australia, this is from our neighboring country Singapore, right? So if you guys if you guys watch many YouTube channels regarding talking about watches, so you will know that Zelos, right, although they are a new brand, they have a, I would say, a cult following, right? So almost every time they release their watches, it will be sold out immediately. So yeah, awesome, awesome watch. Of course the build quality is of course awesome for the money. I went for this stainless steel version with this burgundy sand dial, and the most important, the greatest thing about this particular watch is that it has loomed everywhere, right? So BGW9 plus C3 Super Luminova, and yeah, the case is very, very nice. At about the case size is quite nice at about 40 millimeters in diameter, lug to lug of 46 millimeters, and definitely under 13 millimeters, and the lug width of 20 millimeters, right? So the most annoying thing about this particular watch is the bezel. It's very, very, very difficult to turn. I just wish that Zelos can just use your normal, you know, coin edge bezel to make to give us a lot more grip. Nothing wrong with the click sound, but I struggle every time I wanted to turn this bezel. It's quite annoying, yeah. So anyway, I just love the design, and I might get one soon, maybe in another design, but in their current lineup, this is the only watch that I would buy, because others are just way too big for me. All right, so I've completely forgot to mention the movement. This Monster 4th Gen featuring a 4R36, 4R35, 4R35, and this one also featuring a 4R35 movement, right? So very, very nice. We've got tons of Seiko here, guys. Next up, watch number 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 in my diverse watch lineup. So this is a bit different because it looks like a dive watch, but it has that military dial with those Arabic numeral, and it has that pilot hands, right? So yeah, that's it. That is a quite a weird combination. And if you look at the design of the case, it does looks like an Omega because of that twisted lug. But when you check out that super dome sapphire crystal, it looks absolutely awesome. In my opinion, it looks a bit weird, and it looks a bit, you know, unique in my opinion. But still, for me, it is a great bang for buck watch from Addis Dive. And yeah, kudos to them for trying out something new. And but of course, when you do something new, it will not be to everyone's taste. So that is why one of the reasons why people don't really buy this in truckloads. And of course, the price, somewhere around 110 or 120 bucks. Yeah, not that expensive, but still, I don't really know why people don't like the design, right? So you check out the thin bezel here. Oh, the case 40 millimeters in diameter, lug to lug of 46 millimeters, a thickness because of that super dome, single dome sapphire crystal, it is about 14 millimeters, a bit thick. But if you see the watch, I just love how the watch of the case, it's very, very unique in my opinion, right? So, and of course, we have that C3 vintage loom, which is I think okay, not that bad, but it's not the greatest, but yeah, still an awesome watch for the money, right? So let's go to watch number 11, which is watch number 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Watch number 11. So sorry, guys. So this is another Heimdallah in the collection, Heimdallah Seaghost, which is clearly an homage to the Seamaster and Omega Seamaster, although I'm not really sure which reference are we talking about here, because it fits a bit different dial layout. So those Seamasters, they have that wave pattern, but this one does not, and it is a bit of a light silver color, but of course it still features that ultimately useless, what they call this, helium release, manual helium release escape valve. So I've never even used it. And the great thing about this particular watch is that it is built from titanium, so it is very, very lightweight. I go jogging using this watch because I don't really feel it when it is on the wrist, right? So of course, titanium case, it's gonna be looking a bit dark here compared to the 316L stainless steel. Even the crown is also in titanium, that is why the color is a bit dark here. And yeah, at this side, still very, very nice polishing. Of course, the finishing is very good on with Heimdallah's, but there are two things that need immediate improvement on this particular piece, which is the bezel. I am not going to be turning the bezel because it's very difficult to turn, and it doesn't really have that much grip because of that scallop bezel design, which is similar to the ones that you would find on the Omega Seamaster. But the worst thing about this particular watch is that loom, right? So you can see that the hands. Okay, so let's just give it a quick shaky. Right, so the hands are bit the hour hands and also the minute hands, they don't really have that enough loom to shine bright through the night. So that is why, yeah, that is the most disappointing feature on this Heimdallah Seaghost, right? So yeah, anyway, awesome watch because of the titanium build, but still there are things to improve, right? So that is watch number 11. Let's go to watch number 12, which is this awesome Seiko Mini Turtle. I think the model number is SRPC 39. I might be wrong on that, but still, it is, you know what, I should have been buying this watch. I should have bought this watch a long time ago, because it fits so nice, so well on my wrist. And yeah, finally, during this year's 2021 birthday, I asked my wife, hey, can you buy me a Mini Turtle? And we go to the shop, and I just show her I want that watch for my birthday. And yes, she did, and she bought me this particular watch. And yeah, I just love her. I just love my wife. All right. So anyway, it features 842 millimeters in diameter, but a very, very short 43 millimeters lug to lug from here to here, and a thickness of under 13 millimeters, and with a lug width of 20 millimeters. So that means it sits just very, very nice on my wrist, and I just love using this thing. Right. So that is watch number 12, and let's go to watch number 13, which is another Heimdallah, right? So this is another Heimdallah. This is the Heimdallah Monster V2, right? So Heimdallah Monster V2 is this Of course, an homage to a Seiko Monster, but it homages the Seiko Monster version 3. Whilst that Seiko Monster version 3 has a Cyclop and it had only a date wheel, this one is using, it has this both date and day wheel. Alright, so that is where it differs. And you know what, build quality of this Heimdallr is, oh, you know what, sometimes it feels a lot better compared to the Seiko Monster Gen 2 that I have right there. But still, I'm not going to be selling that one because, you know, it's the OG. But still, for this build quality, you can get it for under $200. Sometimes you can get it for less than $150. You can't really go wrong with this Heimdallr. And of course, on top of that, check out that frost style, guys. So when I saw Heimdallr release this one, I actually put an order for this particular piece in May, but I've only received it somewhere around August. So yeah, that is why it's quite a long wait, but definitely worth the wait, right? So that is watch number 13, right? 13, let's go. That is another Seiko homage, which is the San Martin. This is my second San Martin. And this is homaging the Seiko 62 mask, right? So 42mm in diameter, lug to lug of about 40, I think it's about 49, and a thickness of what? Quite a lot of, I think 14 because of that super dome sapphire crystal. And it has that blue dial with that BSH logo, which stands for Brotherhood of the Submariner homage. And of course, this being the San Martin or San Martin, you can ask them to modify or to just print or custom made your watch according to your taste. And yeah, this is what they have done. So I didn't buy this, but I've traded with my Proxima Scuba Master, another homage to the Seiko Marine Master. And still, I think I'm going tired of this 62 mask design. So maybe this one will go out of the collection at the end of the year. So that is watch number 14. Let's go to watch number 15, which is another Seiko Monster 4th generation, right? So this, when I saw this, the picture of this particular piece, this STO Save the Ocean Antarctica, one thing struck me. You see that? Those feet, those penguin feet. You know what, that is the only reason why I wanted this particular watch. And yeah, I just love that this dial. It looks like a glacier, it looks like a melting ice with that bluish pattern on the outside, and the outer chaptering is basically in dark deeper blue on the outside, and dark, and a softer blue tone in the middle. And those happy feet just makes my heart melt, and I just had to pull the trigger, guys. Although this is the exact same watch as that one, so, but still, because of the dial, I just had to have it, right? So of course, it features the same exact candy bar Cyclops here. And for the first time ever for this fourth gen Monster, we have this stainless steel bezel. And yeah, I just love the Seiko Monster design. And it's quite difficult. Maybe I will keep it, maybe I will not. I'm not really sure at this point of time. So that is watch number 15. And let's go to watch number 16, which is my another San Martin, my third San Martin or San Martin. This is the SN008G, an homage to the Black Bay, right? So I just, you know what, the to the Black Bay 58 is one of the my most, maybe I should call it a grail watch. So it's a thing that I really really want. That is why I can't wait to compare this watch to this particular to the Black Bay 58. But if ever I'm going to buy a Black Bay, I'm going to buy it in this colorway, which is the black and gilt colorway. And yeah, of course, it resembles the Tudor Black Bay 58, but it's actually a bit bigger, and the case shape is quite different, actually. It's a lot more flat, and it features this brushed case finishing versus the polished finishing of the Black Bay 58. And it has this beautiful ceramic bezel insert. And of course, that dial resembles the Tudor black base series, right? So awesome, awesome watch. Oh, 40 millimeters diameter, 48 mil lug to lug, and a thickness of just 11.5 millimeters, guys. So that is awesome, awesome watch, awesome, awesome size, and a lug width of 20 millimeters with paired with that female end link, so making it a very, very comfortable watch on the wrist. And I just love this rivet style bracelet that is available on this Saint Martin BB Black Bay homage, right? So that's watch number 16, and the latest number 17 dive watch in my collection is this Saint Martin SN004G. This is the version 3, where we have this beautiful how to say this, they call this a leather dial, which for me looks like a brown plus a orange-ish, to get paired with that beautiful vintage C3 Super Luminova on the dial. And you know what, it's difficult to get it right, but you can see that it looks like a leather texture, but still it works with the design of this. It mimics those vintage Rolex in 1950s or 1953, I think. And yeah, the case, guys, the case is just 38 millimeters in diameter. If you count the bezel, it will be about 39, and it fits like a glove on my 6.75 inches. This is one of my favorite watch in the Saint Martin collection, right? So in my ever-growing Saint Martin watch collection, right? So you know what, let's go to the most important the most important thing that we should do when we have all of these dive watches together. That is to get an awesome loom shot, right? So I'm just gonna be lining this up so that I can put all in one shot. Let's just put it over there. Okay, guys, so I'm gonna be blasting a bit of this UV light to these watches to see which are the brightest. Of course, this is not a fair comparison, and the room today is not really that dark, so I record this in the maybe 3 or 4 p.m. so yeah, you guys ready? 3, 2, 1. All right, guys, so check that out. Awesome, awesome loom. I just love this. When I see loom, I'm just happy, right? So I'm just so happy to see all this loom. So that is just, you know what, for us loom junkies, we really, really love our loom, right? So yeah, that is all, guys. So if you guys like this video, please give me a thumbs up, and if you want to see more future video reviews such as this one, please go ahead and subscribe to my channel. Until next time, this is my SOTC State of the Watch Collection 2021 October, right? So this watch might not, some of this watch might go, might be not here next year, we'll never know. But yeah, until next time, I'll see you soon. Stay safe, bye bye.